Let the little children come unto me. Where have I heard that before? Good job, good job. Look at these young ones. Maybe if y'all sat there, it'd be better. Let's try that. Let's sit on the front row. Okay, good. I want to tell you something that happened to me just a few days ago as I was driving back up here from Tennessee, 1,000 miles, and I stopped in Virginia to get gas because I was out of gas. Got out of the car, and I was grabbing the trash. I had a paper bag where I put my hamburger and all in it. I stopped at Hardee's, get a hamburger, and ate while I was driving. I didn't text. I didn't see. But stopped to get gas, grabbed the bag, you know, it's laying on the floor, just taking the trash can. Well, this was laying in the middle, and I got it. Trash, and over, good. Reached for my wallet. Wasn't there. I thought, hey, something wrong. Must be in the car. So I opened the door, looked in the car, not there. Looked everywhere. I could. Wasn't there. And I thought, I didn't throw it in the trash can. I wouldn't do that. So I go to the trash can, and I look, not there. Go back to the car. It's got to be in the car. So I look again under every little nip and cranny, up, down, sun visors, every little door that falls between the seats. I thought it was under the seat. Doing this with a flashlight, nowhere. Finally, people behind me wanted to get some gas, so I had to get in the car and move it, although I was about out of gas. I drove over to the edge. What am I going to do? I thought, no need to call Libby. She's going to Alabama. I don't have any money. Deal money. I don't have a driver's license. I don't have credit cards. What am I going to do? I don't recall ever feeling so lost. You know, I just felt I didn't know where to turn. I didn't know what to do. And so I decided to pray. That's all I need to do. When you don't know what else to do, pray. And I prayed. And I got this idea after I prayed, because prayer changes things. If it doesn't change things, it changes us. And it changed me. I wasn't panicking. You know, when you panic, what am I going to do? I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this. That's when you make mistakes. You do bad things when you panic. So I wasn't panicking anymore. I prayed. I think I'll go back to that garbage can. It wasn't in the car. So I go over and everything in that can, I pull it out. These people looking at me, what's wrong with that food? And I'm pulling this nasty stuff, wet stuff. And finally, I saw the receipt at Hardee's. Hey, I'm on to something here. Under the receipt, it was there. And you know, yeah, who said it? So that's what I said. I don't want you to, you know, I felt so good to see you that day. Because I had a future. This is the future. Now, I don't want you to think that prayer is magic, you know. A lot of people think prayer is magic. I mean, when I was your age, I had a Sunday school teacher that told me, he said, if you ever want anything from God, just say the Lord's Prayer, and he'll give it to you. I swear, that's what she said. So I thought I'd try it out. We had a ball game next night, and I said, Lord, let me in a home run. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. I said the whole thing right there, and I was back, getting ready to bat. You know what? I struck out. I said, what good is the Lord's Prayer? I didn't hit a home run. I struck out. She was wrong telling me that. That isn't what prayer is. It's not magic. But it does calm you when you're stressed, when you feel lost, you turn to Jesus. Did you know the Bible says that Jesus came to seek and to save that which was lost? In Jesus' case, he was talking about sheep. In mine, I was talking about my wallet. But it worked. Jesus came to seek and to save that which was lost. Did you know that he had 100 sheep, 99 of them were in the fold. He left them to go after the one that was lost. That's Jesus. He seeks and saves that which is lost. So don't forget to pray, young people. You might just find what you're looking for.
He comes for me.